I'm Julie Goodnight, and this is another Daily Dose of Horsemanship Homework. I'm working today with Woodrow. He's a three-year-old quarter horse gelding, and he is quite the pistol. And he's a hot-blooded horse that's just full of himself, but he's sensitive, he's smart, quick-learning, a super fun horse to work with, although he's not always easy. And today's lesson is encircling work on the lead line. So we're going to advance the ground manners work that I've been doing with Woodrow today. I have not done any circling work with him previously. And before we get started, just a couple of moments about equipment and safety. I've got the horse outfitted in a rope halter and a 15-foot training lead. This is a heavy marine rope, yacht rope. You'll see there's no buckle under the chin. The rope halter works better at this kind of groundwork than a flat halter because the horse won't lean on it and pull on it as much. So you need to have something in your hands when you're doing circling work with the horse, whether it's in the round pen, on a lead line, or on a lunge line. You should always have something in your hand. For this kind of close-in work, we want about a four-foot stick. I prefer a rigid stick and a flag. My flags are very lightweight and balanced, making them easy to hold and making them an excellent communication tool. The flag is just another tool at your disposal that is a great signaling device. The horse can see it well. It has movement, it has sound. It can really capture the attention of the horse. So I'm only going to use my flag and stick in reinforcement when I need to. And the rest of the time, I'm going to keep it back here behind me so it's not bothering him. But if I need to move him away from me or speed him up, I'll bring that flag out to create more distance between the horse and me. Now, when you do this kind of close-in circling work on the lead line, it is not hard at all for the horses to get amped up, to get cranked up. And it is common for the horse to kick out while you're doing this. That doesn't make him a bad horse. That makes him a normal horse. That's what horses do. And you see it all the time out in the paddock. When a dominant horse is chasing away a subordinate horse, that subordinate horse will kick out and run away. So I expect him to kick out while I'm doing this work. It's my job to stay out of the way of the kick. I know he can kick the full length of his leg to the side. I want to double that distance to be sure. So I'm never going to get any closer to him than twice the distance of his hind leg. And that's another reason why you want to carry a stick or a flag to help signal the horse and control the horse. So this circling work gets into the more advanced realm of groundwork with your horse. It refines your communication with the horse. It will give you better control of all parts of the horse's body. We're going to move his nose. We're going to move his feet. We're going to move his shoulder. We're going to move his hip. We're going to change his direction. And most importantly, perhaps, is we're going to teach him a solid yes, ma'am attitude through this exercise. We're going to teach him a work ethic that when I ask you to do something, you need to say yes, ma'am, and jump right to it and do it until I tell you to stop. So this may start out being somewhat forceful and demonstrative, but I want it to end up very dance-like, very communication-like. So first thing I'll do is, before I start, I want to make sure that you understand that whenever you're working a horse on the circle, whether you have a line and a whip or stick or whatever, your hand that is closest to the head of the horse is called the lead hand, and your hand that is closest to the tail of the horse is called the whip hand. When you change directions, you have to change hands. And we only signal the horse with the whip hand. And that'll become obvious here in just a minute. So I'm always going to start with a hand signal. I like to always use hand signals with my horses. It's very easy to teach horses hand signals, and they respond quite well to them. He doesn't know what my signals mean yet. So I'm going to give him the cue to go in the direction I want him to go, and then I'll use my flag to reinforce. So I'll turn and look and point, ask him to go, and then use the flag. And I want him to just move in a a circle around me and go out on the line. I want to give them as much lead line as I can. And the first thing that's important to understand when you're doing circling work with horses is that you're driving the horse from behind. So the balance point of the horse is in the girth area. So if you see his brand on his shoulder, the girth area is the indentation behind that where his elbow is. And that's what we call the balance point of the horse, or the drive line of the horse. And I'll point to it right now. So whenever you're working the horse on the circle, I have to stay behind the drive line, and my signaling all has to occur behind the drive line. If I get in front of the horse, it blocks their trajectory, and they see that immediately, and it causes them to stop or turn around and go the other way. So I'm going to now just ask him to go in a circle around me the other way. So I just changed my whip hand and my lead hand. I'm going to slide my hand down the rope, point and look in the new direction, ask him to move, good boy, reinforce with the flag as needed. So I want the horse to be working at a nice, brisk, working trot. This is an exercise where he has to learn to work. And I'll step in front, change my hands, slide my hand down the rope, point, ask him to go the other way. So remember, I'm staying behind the horse. Notice that I'm walking towards the hip of the horse. I am not walking backwards. I'm not walking sideways, because this happens. Now all of a sudden, I'm the one making the circle. So I want to be driving my horse forward on a loose line. I'll step in front, change hands, slide my hand down, point and look, ask him to go. One. Now, whoa. He's doing really, really well. And there's a couple of reasons why. One is, he has been started under saddle and he's been lunged in that process. So it's not like it's the first time he's ever gone in a circle. Secondly, I just finished working him a few minutes ago in the round pen, and we worked on all these principles with him at Liberty. So some of this is just carrying on from what we've already worked on, and some of it is because Mel has been lunging him off and on as she saddled him and all of that. So he's doing really great. And but unfortunately, that means you don't get to see some of the things that are challenging when you're training a horse to circle. So your number one challenge in the circling work is, can you get the horse going in both directions without him trying to turn around or pull on you or drag you to the gate? Most people don't have trouble going to the left, but they will have trouble going to the right. So that's something you and your horse will have to work out. And that is most likely going to become a problem of you getting out of position with your horse, you getting in front of him or not being at the right in the right place to get him to circle around you to the right. So that's step one, just can you get the horse going in both directions? Step two, which is what you just saw me do, was to start change directions. And he was picking up on that really fast. So I want to come back to that in just a minute. So I'm going to throw in just a little intermediate step that I like to do when I'm training a horse for the first time in this circling work. So once I have successfully circled the horse around me at a working trot in both directions without him pulling on the lead or trying to turn around, the next thing I want to do is teach him to stop. And this doesn't really have to do with the circling work. It's just a good time to do it. And I'm going to issue the whoa command with my voice. Then I am going to plant my feet in a very obvious way. And then if he has not come to a complete stop, I'm going to reinforce that cue with the rope. And I just want to see how long it takes until when I just say the word, he screeches to a halt. So we will give it a try. So once you go that way, please. Good. Now, that time he just took off without me bringing the flag out, so that was nice. Wanted to move out away from me on a little bit bigger circle than that. So remember, before we work on stops, either on the ground or in the saddle, you want to make sure you're moving that horse forward a lot first. So I want him to be looking for that stop cue. I want him to want to stop and to appreciate the stop. Now, this is Alistair Woodrow, as I was talking about stopping, so he just thought he would stop. Okay, so I'm going to give him the voice cue, followed by the body language cue, followed by the rope. Whoa, feet, rope. Good boy. Now, that was really good. Figured it out all by himself, but he stopped, but then he started coming towards me. So I used the rope, and I don't want him to think this is a cue to come to me. I want him to think it's a cue to slam on the brakes and stop. He will turn and face me at this stage, and I'm fine with that because we wind up in a good position. So now I'm going to ask him to go the other way. Now, remember I said I have to be behind the drive line of the horse in order to push him away from me. But from this position, I'm nowhere near that. I'm way in front of the drive line of the horse. So what you want to learn to do is to move the horse rather than you move. So watch what happens. If I try to relocate my position so that I am behind the drive line of the horse, what the horse is going to learn to do is just turn and face you so you never get to the drive line of the horse. So you don't want your horse to learn that trickery. So instead, always move the horse. So from this position here, where I need him to go is that way. So I kind of bump the lead and point, bring my flag up, and once I move the shoulders of the horse around, I'm now behind the drive line, so I can drive him forward. So we'll go forward, forward, forward. Now I'll give him a cue. Whoa. That was good. That was good. He cracked me up. Okay. Very good. So that way. Good boy. So you see how the horse is starting to listen to me. He's starting to focus on me for cues. He's starting to accept my sign language as a line of communication. So we'll try that stop cue one more time. So remember that in the stop, your rope or your reins are the reinforcement to the cue and not the cue itself. So the cue to stop was when I said whoa and I planted my feet. The reinforcement came with the rope. Learning occurs when the horse responds to the cue and the reinforcement is no longer needed. So make sure you aren't using your rope to stop your horse. Now, only one more thing we have to think about in today's lesson.
Good boy.
So notice that as he starts understanding what I'm asking, I'm going to slow down my cues. I'm going to make my cues slower and more gesture-like. I'm going to be using the rope less. So now we want to work on changes of direction. I'm not going to say the magic word. I'm simply going to step in front, change my hand, point in a new direction, ask the horse to move his nose, then his shoulder, and then his hind end. So watch again, I step in front, change hands, point and bump, move the shoulder. The main thing that you have to watch out for here is that the horse moves the shoulder away from you right here. If he comes into you with his shoulder on that turn, so right here, I need him to move away from me with his shoulder. And this is a really important part because, good boy. Okay, I'm just gonna let him settle. He's getting a little mad there. Now, often I talk about horses that have a very strong sense of right or wrong, and Woodrow is one of them. So is my horse Pepperoni. And these are often horses that we refer to as being temperamental or having occasional temper tantrums. If you can really get inside that horse's head and understand what makes him mad, I was asking him to circle around me, and Mel was standing in the way with the camera. And so that put him between a rock and a hard place. He knew he wasn't supposed to run over Mel, but he knew he couldn't come towards me either. And so his antics just then, that was not a temper tantrum because he was just being a brat. That was him expressing his emotion because he felt trapped and he felt like there was no right answer there. And he felt like what we were doing, in particular me, what I was doing, which was pushing him into Mal, was wrong. So he expressed himself. Now, I don't have to cave in and say, oh, you're right, I'm wrong, I'm a terrible person. But if I had then criticized him and engaged with him because he got a little mad right there, I would have started a fight with a horse over something that was actually my fault. So with these horses with a very strong sense of right and wrong, you have to be very careful not to exacerbate their temper or exacerbate their strong sense of right and wrong. In other words, you can prove to them that they were right and you were wrong by reacting in the wrong way to that kind of temper tantrum. So I think he actually did great in this lesson. For the first time that we've worked together circling on the lead line. So step number one, is can you get that horse going in both directions around you without the horse pulling on you or crowding into you or pulling you towards the gate? Step two, let's go ahead and teach the whoa command. Go ahead and teach that horse to stop off both your verbal cue and your body language cue. And in step three, we're going to work on changing the direction of the horse, making most certain that the horse is taking great care to move his shoulder away from you and not coming towards you with his shoulder in that turnaround, which is a very common passive-aggressive move, of course. So as he turns around on this lead line, he should be moving away from me. If he comes towards me and forces me to step back, he's doing that intentionally, and he's moving me out of my space, so he's gaining ground and dominance on me with every turn I make. So make sure you don't get kicked. Make sure you use the right tools and have fun with this exercise. As the horse starts learning, make your cues smaller and smaller, more gesture-like, more dance-like with your horse until that horse is just moving with you. From there, we're going to do these same maneuvers without a lead line, without a halter and lead line. We're going to do the circling work at liberty. It's easier than you think. So spend a little time on this exercise. I'm Julie Goodnight. This is Woodrow, and thank you for joining us for another Daily Dose of Horsemanship Homework.